Now, this is a question I get asked all the time because, you know, if on the show, we've talked about reincarnation, about past lives, about near-death experiences, things like that. Many of these ideas are thousands and thousands and thousands, some of the oldest ideas, pre-religion, pre-organized religion even. But people always have this one question, like, why do we forget? Why is it necessary for us not to remember these quote-unquote past lives? I always say, you can barely deal with the life you have. Can you imagine having the memory of like four or five other lives where there's trauma and there's pain and there's suffering? How do you think psychologically you could deal with it? But I'd love to hear your point of view on it.
Yeah, no, exactly. So first of all, the forgetting is additive for a few reasons. Okay. One, you are, okay, if you want to fully experience being the human, you got to be the human, man. You know, if you want to be Zelda, you got to be Zelda. You can't be Contra. Contra's not in Zelda. There's no Contra in Zelda.
Nope.
There's just Zelda in Zelda, right? Mm-hmm. So if you want to be the human in your story, then you need to surrender and let go of everything else to be fully immersed in your human perspective. That full immersion is precisely where the value is. So it actually adds perspective value when you can forget everything else and only have the perspective of being Alex or whoever is listening today. And then it's also additive because, like you said, you are basically free from... So we do have qualities that we carry from life to life because we are the same soul from given life to life. But a given lifetime might develop certain attachments, form associations, and ego patterns. And so it can be helpful to let that go. And like the root fear, if it's unaddressed, could remain from one experience to another. But let's say in one life, you really strongly associate with some conservative religious affiliation. And let's say you're a terrorist or something. Mm-hmm. You know, if you live another life, that whole association is not even there anymore. It's gone. Like you have no memory of that. Now you're still you, but now you get a fresh slate. Now you get to start completely over. You have to learn everything over again, all the language, all the patterns of life, everything your parents teach you, everything has to be relearned. But that's not just negative. It's like a new, it's like being given a brand new set of cards.
Or starting the level over again. You're starting the level over again, but without any information about the game.
Right. Well, it's like, well, you do. Yeah, you do actually, the soul level, you do have some information.
Sure.
It's like starting a brand new game so that you can just play that game. And that is what playing that game is about.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that's the most concise way to put that. And the third reason is that being veiled protects us from homesickness. Mm-hmm. Because the depth of joy and love and freedom that we really are is, oh my gosh, it's breathtakingly deep and vast and huge. And to have recollection of that can be debilitating. Like, how are you going to get up and go to work in the morning if you knew, for instance, that the sun was in you right now? You could feel it. Like, I say that because in my pre-birth experience, I felt that. I knew the sun was in me. The sun is a part. I'm a part of it. I'm a part of the sun. Sounds wild from the human point of view, but from there I could feel it. I just consciously feel it in my body. So imagine if you could feel that in the body of your awareness, how would you go to McDonald's and order your coffee? You know, you couldn't. So in that sense, the veil is enabling. And then what's important is, like, if you imagine the veil, like locking someone into a position, and then you work within that position and you refine. And then when you let the veil off, now you expand back out because you did all this work at a limited place. Like maybe if you wore a 100-pound coat,
mm-hmm.
you put the coat on. Now you got to walk around for a whole lifetime, this 100-pound coat. You learn how to walk with 100 pounds on you. And then when you take it off, oh, the 100 pounds aren't native to me, but you retain the ability to walk that you develop. You retain the strength. Yeah.
To watch the full video, click on the link below and don't forget to subscribe.